I'm Jessica Romano with Carnegie Museum of Natural History, and today I'm talking to Dr. John Wible, curator and head of the section of mammals. You are a part of an international team of scientists who recently announced an amazing discovery, a fossil mammal from Madagascar. What can you tell me about this new discovery, and also specifically how it got its nickname, Crazy Beast?
Discovery of this fossil is really quite an amazing story, and it's probably way too long to go into a lot of detail, but the short version would be that this fossil was actually discovered in 1999. So it took 21 years to get this to publication. That's kind of a long time in the scheme of things, but there's a lot of backstories as to why it took so long. When the people that found it in northwest Madagascar were looking at the surface of the exposures that they were playing in, they saw a lot of crocodile bones. So these would obviously be ancient crocodiles. And it was toward the end of the field season, so they decided that they would just take a big block of that would include these crocodile bones. So they made a big plaster jacket, which is how they deal with fossils of that size. And they crated it up and sent it back to New York. When it got to New York, there was a preparator that started working with these crocodile bones and all of a sudden discovered that there was an elbow joint of something much smaller than a crocodile. And they rushed this off to an X-ray machine, a gigantic X-ray machine, and discovered there was an entire skeleton of a little curled up mammal. And that was this new discovery. So I was just one member of a large international team that was organized by the head curator of vertebrate paleontology at the Denver Museum of Nature and Science, Dave Krause. And Dave invited me a few years ago to be involved in this project. So I've not been involved with this for 21 years since the discovery. I came on in the last couple of years of this project to try to get it to its end point. This really is one of the most amazingly well-preserved fossil mammals that we know. So you think about all the little bones that are in your hands and feet, they're all there with this fossil. By the standards of mammals of its time, it was a giant. So this is a fossil that's in the close to the very end of the age of dinosaurs, about somewhere between 70 and 66 million years ago. And it was about the size of our local opossum here for scale. But by the standards, again, most of the contemporary fossils of mammals were about the size of a shrew or a mouse. So a possum-sized animal, every time you name a new species, it has to have distinguishing features that set it off from other species that are known to science. So this new animal, Adalatherium huai, is, of course, unique and distinct from other mammals. Its name, Adalatherium, translate in Malagash, the first part, Adala, means crazy, and therium is actually Greek for beast. So it was named specifically by us as Crazy Beast in recognition of how weird it is. There are no analogs among living mammals or even closely related or other fossil mammals that are anywhere near the strangeness of this animal.
Wow. I mean, that's really amazing and exciting, I think, too.
Absolutely. Anytime you can, you're the first ones to look at something new to science, and then you bring that forward to other scientists and to the public, it's an incredibly exciting endeavor to be a part of.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So your research typically follows the evolutionary tree of life for mammals. How did you fit this mammal on the evolutionary tree of life?
This was such a weird animal that it just didn't really fit very easily. So it has teeth that are just remarkably unlike anything. We compare these teeth to other things, it just doesn't fit in. What we basically do is make up a gigantic chart or grid that has all these different features on one side of the grid, and then the animals that we're comparing it to on the other side. And you then go through various features, and a feature could be something like, you know, how many teeth are there in the upper jaw, or what bones form this foramen in the skull, this hole in the skull. And then ultimately it goes through a computer program that makes our work a lot easier, and it spits out a tree that's kind of like if you go to ancestry websites and put in your data and you have your DNA in there, and it spits out a tree as well. So it's very similar in terms of the mechanism to that in some regards. So our tree that we got at the end of the day showed us that this was related to another animal that's we know from Madagascar, and then some other mammals that were at a similar time period exclusively on southern continents. So Adalatherium is a member of a group that's exclusively known from the southern continents at the end of the age of dinosaurs, and then a little bit into the age of mammals after the asteroid impact 66 million years ago that wiped out the dinosaurs. The group that this belongs to are known as Gondwanatherians.
Can you tell me a little bit about the features of this mammal, specifically in the skull, that make it so unique?
Right, so it turns out that my area of specialty is actually the skull of mammals. So when I saw this skull, I was immediately freaked out by how weird it was, because it had things that I had never seen before in any other specimen, and I've seen a lot of specimens over my time. On the top of the snout, right down the middle, there's a hole in what we would call the nasal bones. Now, our nasal bones are just this little tiny bridge here, but if you think about a dog with an elongate snout, they have quite sizable nasal bones. So there's a hole right in the middle of the nasal bones. I've never seen anything like this. We had to actually give it a name because it's not known to science. But what was this thing doing? I mean, we have absolutely no idea, because again, there's no, you're always looking for living analogs. Is there some living mammal that has anything like this that can give us some clue to a function for it? We've got nothing. We called it the internasal vacuity, which is a fancy thing for saying that it's a hole between the nasal bones. But that's the thing about the fossil record, is that there's always the next fossil to discover that's gonna help you piece together this giant puzzle that is the tree of life and our biodiversity on our planet. So it's kind of like a detective enterprise where you have to use all your skills to try to figure out what something is.
Thank you so much for sharing this amazing discovery with me.
Thank you for asking about it and showing interest, and I hope the public enjoys it as well.